Hey, and welcome to a very special edition of the Drive Time Show with Vernon Howl, vernonhowl.com. Somber episode 5, the 23rd day of May 2012. I'm actually heading back from a funeral service. A friend of mine's mother passed away unexpectedly recently. So I decided to do a show while I'm driving home. Getting on back on the road, so this will be an extended multi-part episode of the Drive Time Show. So the youtube.com, my allowance is only 15 minutes max clips. I assume that this will be at least a three-part episode, so I will be breaking it up into probably three, maybe four 15-minute clips, depending on how long it takes me to get back to the office. And then this will be the, this is a special edition of the show. And like I said, it's 11:48 in the a.m. I'm heading back to work after having gone to a funeral. 5/23/12 is the date. I'm in the northern part of central New Jersey, if that makes sense to some people, driving down, going back to work. You're listening to episode 5, Vernon Howl's Drive Time. It's Drive Time with Vernon Howl. I'm your host, Vernon Howl. I saw a lot of people I had not seen since I was very young. A lot of parents of kids I grew up with, and it was... it's always terribly awkward for me to go into places to begin with. But I think that it was. I'm probably a little bit better now than I was. And, if I could be honest with you for 1 second, I just, in my head right now, if you noticed that I was kind of not there for the last 45 seconds, that's because I was kind of questioning this whole radio talk, car talk show idea, and wondering if, and, well, really, it, so it comes down to is... my reasoning behind doing this is because I feel like this is otherwise time wasted if I'm just in my car and, you know, listening to music, even though I can listen to any song I want to pretty much because I have those capabilities via this device that I'm using right now to talk into, the iPhone 4. I still feel that I'm not quite utilizing the my potential, if that makes sense. I just feel like that I have to be doing something, and this is something. So it goes back to the idea of, you know, I need to create this content, and you have a limited amount of time, so. What else can you really do while driving? I can't paint a picture while I'm driving. I can't write a song. You know, I've actually written songs while driving from my Twitpella series, which is my short a cappella series that I debut on Twitter. But, there is a limit to what kind of art one can create while they're driving an automobile. And this idea of modern society, that we spend so much time in our cars, you spend a life in your car, really, think about it. I'm lucky. I don't have to be in my car quite nearly as much as most people. And I've talked about this before, because my commute is so small. In this case, I'm driving from funeral, so I have about a 45-minute drive. You know, a good 45-minute drive. I started this show after I was on the road for a little while, so I think this will probably come in at under 45, I would assume. Like I said, separating the three parts, but I at the same time, I don't really know if this is what I want to be doing right now. And I was thinking in my head just then of what other things could I be doing other than the talk show. And I like the idea of the talk show in so much as it's an unfiltered look into who I really am, because I sent out a tweet the other day that that I'm being 65% more earnest in this show than I am in at least 55, and I capitalized at least 50% of my other projects and works and artistic works in any other fashion. You could question whether what I'm doing here is an artistic work at all, and that would be totally right to do that. I just had a quick thought about I wanted to get fast food maybe for long. I haven't eaten lunch. There was food at the thing, but I couldn't, you know, my dad was there and he was leaving because he was kind of like, you know, tapped out of, you know, I could tell. And my dad's a pretty social guy, but he was, you know, I think he kind of spent it on those people and he was just, he was ready to get on with it. And I respected that decision to bail, and I was just like, yeah, I hear you. I'm bailing too. So we didn't eat any food, although they had some like good Italian looking food, like just regular catered Italian looking food, like garlic bread and some salad with like a balsamic vinaigrette and lasagnas and things, ziti and maybe just ziti and some other, maybe a meatball. I didn't see the end of the buffet table, but people were starting to eat, but it was very crowded. And so, but anyway, so yeah. What I'm thinking of is, and I think I'm going to stop, so that'll be one way to break this up into segments is when I stop. But, okay, so I had to make sure this was still recording, because the other day I missed the last, changed lanes, I'm on the highway right now. So I had, you know, I had this thought that to end the show and erase all the episodes, because maybe that I was giving away, and I think this has part to do with the fact that I just saw people that I know. So all right, so there's two things. I make art under a pseudonym, and when I say my name is Vernon Howl on the show, obviously it's not my real name. I have a real life. So this, and I don't touch on it exclusively here at all. I mean, maybe 10% of, less than 10% of this, of all this, these car shows that I've done, talk shows, probably under 5% of it have been me talking about like things I do in real life. They're more general thoughts about art and about how I feel and just how both of those things kind of relate to one another. And that's always, you know, that theme, the theme is a tired, probably one, it's probably a tired theme, but the theme of like art about the process and about the idea of wanting to be an artist and wanting to maybe be acknowledged and the kind of ridiculousness of creative people or people who, you know, how stupid people, just the idea of creativity is and how. And I'm being facetious in a way because I obviously I think that there's merits to it, and I you know, I'm influenced, and you know, I owe a lot to people who are been successful in it, and even people who are not, in all of the arts, you know, all of the art forms that they may take, whether music, art, literature, painting, poetry, and it reminds me of there's a Kickstarter campaign I just backed from a rapper named Mission Man from Oxford, Ohio, and he's probably mid-30s, he's been around trying to be a rapper and that, and he works at Papa John's, and that's what he does, and he's funding a Kickstarter. He's only looking for $700 total, and he has five backers, and I'm one of the five backers, and I will do what I can to, you know, he has more Twitter followers than I do, so take that for what it's worth. But the idea that he can't even get $700, and, you know, he was blocked. WFMU, which is a radio station, independent radio station in New Jersey, very famous, and, you know, they very famous network of radio stations, and they do a lot of web stuff, and they have a blog, and they blogged about him. And I'm like, still, this guy only has five backers, so it's not just about that. It's not just about when I think of things I want to talk about and why I should still do this show and why it's important to kind of for me to sit in my car and, you know, kind of manically occasionally and, you know, and just kind of off the cuff randomly speak to myself into an iPhone 4 as I drive. Seems ridiculous. And in truth, I'm really not giving away too much of it. But if you want to know the truth, is here. I'm a guy. I'm just a guy myself, and I do this whole artistic thing and this endeavor, and I keep it very much separate from who I am as this person. And my name is beep beep. You know, that's me beeping out my actual real name. So I have this whole life. I have a mother and a father and a brother and a sister and a wife and a dog. And possibly children. At some point, I'm a 31-year-old man. I have a job, which I refer to here because this is when I typically record the show, is on to and from, usually from or back, going home from the place where I work. And I have a lot of people come in contact with are completely clueless, or at least on the surface level, there's no mutual understanding as to these two personalities. And I often wonder why that is, and if I were to one day just say, listen, I am Vernon Howl. And I believe in the idea of a pseudonym, and there's no reason why, and I'm not trying to hide. Fuck, I just hit a huge hot pothole. It's not about being not, it's not so much really. I know it seems like, oh, you're not okay with who you are and you're embarrassed by this. I'm not really embarrassed by it at all. I guess that's part of it. It's more of a confidence factor and lacking in confidence doing with the work. And I have a degree in fine arts, a bachelor's degree, and I'm been strongly considering going back for an MFA, which I don't know if I mentioned that before, but with the possibility of teaching and being a college professor when we went in the line. I'll be 32 if I start an MFA program in the Northeast somewhere. So my life will significantly change I guess it would probably have to be, I wouldn't be able to apply until January. I don't think I could get into any programs until the fall semester of 2013. I don't think most graduate programs don't allow you to do, so I couldn't start it, definitely couldn't probably start it for the fall of 2012 coming up. This is May 2012. I don't think that's a possibility as far as when you can apply for these things. You can only apply once a year. So I'd be 32, and I'd be starting. So that's really not so bad. That's a possibility. That's down the line. And I think at that point, it becomes clear that I'm at least engaged in arts on a... The arts have taken enough of my money where it'd be stupid not to just full-on embrace it, because I don't think you never know what avenue I have not been able to... venture down due to my wanting to create things on the internet primarily anonymously.